App stores are central to how we use our smartphones. If you're on Android, you probably get all your apps from the Google Play Store. And if you're on iOS, you get your apps from the Apple App Store. They're convenient digital marketplaces, one-stop shops that catalog all kinds of add-on tools for your phone. But there's a catch. To access these app stores, you first have to sign in to an account. This allows you to manage your histories, preferences, and transactions across devices. It might seem innocuous, but it's actually a big privacy concern. In this video, we're going to explain the problems with tying all your downloads to a single identity, and we'll give you two options for more privacy-preserving app stores that you can use instead when you download apps to your phone. First, let's address the privacy concerns of app stores like Google Play and the Apple App Store. These app stores act as a single gateway for all your apps, tying each in-store purchase and download to a central identity. This way, Google and Apple can aggregate data on your app preferences, usage patterns, and even in-app behavior if developers use their analytics services. This can paint a comprehensive picture of your interests, behavior, even social connections, health, and financial information. The more data they have, the more accurate and intrusive their profiles become. These centralized accounts can also enable tracking of users' activities across different platforms and devices, which means that these companies can monitor users' behavior not just on their smartphones, but also on tablets, computers, and other connected devices. We've talked a lot in the past about why you should try to minimize the amount of data that's collected about you. Google, for example, shares your data with thousands of different companies in their real-time bidding systems. And those companies then sell or share that data with countless more. You don't know into whose hands this data will ultimately land, how many data breaches it will then become part of, and you have no control over whether it will be misused. And like other major tech companies, Apple also collects a lot of data from users. While Apple sets itself apart from the others in the way that they utilize this data, they're still collecting it. You have to trust that they are protecting this data, which isn't always the case. By consolidating your digital activities under one identity, it becomes harder to compartmentalize your online life and protect your personal information. It can erode the concept of anonymity on the internet, making it easier for someone to identify you and track your behavior. Luckily, you don't actually have to use app stores that force you into their identity system. Apple is rumored to be allowing alternative app stores on their phone as early as this year. And if you're an Android or GrapheneOS phone user, there are already alternative app stores that you can use. Before we dive into them, an important note to mention is that the usage of these alternative app stores alone isn't enough to protect you from data collection, because your device itself collects a lot of data about you. So we highly recommend that you install these app stores on a GrapheneOS phone if it's real privacy that you're after. The first alternative app store that we'll mention is F-Droid. It's an open source app store that focuses on providing free and open source software applications for Android devices. You can donate to developers, but none of the apps or games cost anything. There's a big difference between F-Droid and the Google Play Store when it comes to privacy, and that starts with the lack of Google, specifically Google Play services, which are required to use the Google Play Store. This includes a collection of proprietary background services and APIs that are bundled with Android devices. These Google services are incredibly invasive, constantly communicating with Google's infrastructure. Unlike the Google Play App Store, you don't need Google Play services for the F-Droid App Store. Next, F-Droid doesn't require users to create an account or provide any personal information to access the App Store. This means that a user's identity is not tied to their downloads or app usage, so it's much better for privacy than the Google or Apple app stores. F-Droid also makes sure that apps have clear permissions, so that the user understands the data that an app can access. Some apps are labeled with anti-features, which are things that a privacy-conscious person might want to be aware of before they download the app. F-Droid curates their app selection, aiming to block apps that contain any tracking or advertising features. Of course, this doesn't guarantee safety or prevent custom trackers, so it's still important that you only install apps if you trust the developers of that app. F-Droid is also unlike the Google and Apple app stores in that they build the apps from the source code themselves, rather than relying on the developer to serve them a built app. Normally, we have no way of knowing whether open source code that's publicly available for something is the same code that we're being served in an app store. With F-Droid doing the builds themselves directly from the code, the user has more assurance of the code that they're getting. It does require you to trust that F-Droid's build server hasn't been compromised, and there was an issue in the past where they were using an OS that was no longer supported. Now, one possible downside of F-Droid's requirement to build the app themselves is the time it takes for updates to appear. While they can be released quickly on other app stores, there can be a lag on F-Droid while the developer waits for F-Droid to build the updated version. Just like with all app stores, F-Droid is not bulletproof. While they provide checks on apps to filter for malware, the code checks are usually quite basic and involve automated processes. So just as malware can get into the Google Store and Apple stores, you should presume that it can also get into the F-Droid store. So as always, be careful what you download. We think F-Droid is one of the best alternatives out there to the Play Store, especially for people looking to create a de-Googled life. Many of the more private app alternatives that we mention on this channel are available on F-Droid. But for all of those that aren't, we recommend the Aurora Store. You can think of it like a more private front end to the Google Play Store. It's an unofficial, open-sourced alternative to the Google Play Store and allows users to download Android apps from the Google Play Store without having to sign in to any Google account first, giving the user more privacy. The Aurora Store also allows users to spoof their device information, making it appear as if they're using a different device than the one that they're actually using, which helps protect from device fingerprinting and certain tracking techniques. This can also allow you to download apps that are otherwise restricted by region. When searching the Aurora Store, you can filter apps based on various criteria, such as whether the app contains ads or requires specific permissions, so you can make more informed decisions about the apps that you choose to download and use. One downside is that sometimes you might find no results come up for certain apps in the Aurora Store. This doesn't mean that the app isn't there, and you can actually find it by using a Google Play link. To do this on a Graphenephone, first go to Settings, Apps, and select the Aurora app. Scroll down and click Open by Default, and then click Add Link. You'll have an option to check play.google.com. Select that and save out. Now, anytime you go to a website and they only have a link to the Google Play Store, you can click that link and it will open in the Aurora Store instead. Using the Aurora Store anonymously will stop Google linking all of your app usage together and tying it to your Google identity. But it's worth noting that it doesn't stop the app developers themselves spying on you through their apps. So be judicious about which apps you download. Another advantage of using F-Droid or the Aurora Store that's worth mentioning is that there's no longer a single gatekeeper for all your app downloads. While most people get all of their apps from the Google Play Store or the Apple App Store, the selection is filtered by Google and Apple, and further limited by your geographical location and other factors. F-Droid and Aurora put a larger choice of apps at your fingertips. The Google Play Store and Apple App Store are convenient one-stop shops for your phones, but the privacy concerns of centralizing your digital activities under one account shouldn't be ignored. Alternative app stores like F-Droid and Aurora not only allow you to enjoy phone apps without tying them to a single identity, but they also give you a greater variety of app choices, including those that are better for your privacy. So have a think about making the switch to Grapheneand taking advantage of these alternative app stores. We have a free tutorial online that walks you through the entire Grapheneinstallation process, and we also offer consultation services with our technicians who can walk through the entire process with you if you require more help. It's time to take control of your digital life and better protect your personal information. And your phone is a great place to start. NBTV is funded by community donations. If you'd like to support our free educational content, please visit nbtv.media/support. We also have a book, Beginner's Introduction to Privacy, that also supports our channel. Also, liking, sharing, and commenting on our videos also really, really helps. Thank you so much for watching through till the end.